Hello, Mario! In this video, we're going to be looking at how to find errors in traverses. This is gross errors, either a gross error in a bearing or a gross error in a distance. Usually these are resulted from the wrong information being input, transposition of figures and that sort of thing. So I'm going to show you a few tips on how you might find an error when your traverse doesn't close. Here we have a traverse from a previous video of mine. These are the final closing coordinates and we've showed that it all closes. Now what we're going to do is we're going to change one of the bearings and one of the distances on separate occasions in this from this particular traverse and see what effect it has on the close and how we might go about nailing down where the error is and isolating it. It's probably a good idea if you have a copy of this plan in front of you. So if you don't have one available, you could either take a screenshot or you can send me an email, mario@mario.com, and I'll forward it to you. Just give me a bit of detail as to what it is you're after so that you get the right stuff. So there, this is the traverse that we're going to be dealing with in this. Just to put a bit of a context around things, gross errors in measurements will manifest themselves in a traverse misclose. The gross errors are typically a distance and or bearing error. Now, we're required to explain how you would identify the individual bearing and distance measurement errors by analysing a traverse misclose. Now, you could use the field traverse in question 13, which was the one that I put up there as an example and create an artificial measurement error in firstly the bearing and then in the distance in one line of the traverse and show how it manifests itself. We need to show this on a traverse sheet with the RF misclose calculated for the traverse block. Discuss the misclose, how it points you towards the source of the gross error. You need to show two separate examples, one with a bearing error and one with a distance error. And here we have the particular traverse sheet. What we did here was I changed this bearing here, 128.33.10, to 120.33.10, a common error where we mistake an 8 for a 0. So, as usual, we just doesn't particularly matter here that I've sort of, that should be iron tube 4 there. It doesn't really matter for the purposes of this exercise. So here we are. I've put the wrong bearing in there and we can see that we get a misclose, 6 meters and 4.19. So what we do is using techniques that I've showed in other videos, we are able to determine what the misclose is. In this case it's a misclose of 7.46 meters on a bearing of 34 degrees 10 minutes 48 which we have determined. So we can see here that 34 is, we can look through here and see that this bearing here 120 is sort of very close to 30, so it's indicating a possible bearing error because the actual misclose is at right angles to that line. So we can investigate in there and start looking at, that's the first line that we'd look at, and because we changed it ourselves, of course we know that that's exactly where the problem is. So that's that one. So the thing to do is to look for the bearings that are at right angles to the particular line in question. In the second example, I have changed the distance 53.49 to 35.49. That's typically a transposition of the figures. And once again, we run the bearing closure out as previously, and we find that we get a bearing misclose or a misclose of 11 meters and 14. We determine the extent of the misclose, which is 18 meters. At a bearing of 308 degrees 20 minutes and 48 seconds, and we can see that 308 degrees and is almost 180 degrees different to 128.33 in here. So that points us to a difference in that line. So the mist close is nearly on the same bearing as that. So looking at that, remember that the bearings can be 180 degrees different. So it's nearly on the same bearing and it's 18 meters. Another indication there is when we get a mist close or distance like that, if we add the 1 and 8 together, it equals 9. And that, where we add errors together, the 1s and the 10s or whatever, and we get 9, that usually indicates that there's some sort of transposition problem going on. So in this case here, we know we can sort of indicate to look at there, look at the transposition, and it should perhaps be 53.49, which we know it is, because that's how we set it out. So there you go. There's two little quick little tips with regards to finding errors in bearings and distances, and that is to look at lines that are at right angles to the bearing of the mist close can give you an indication of things going wrong, and also look at lines that are on the same bearing or 180 degrees different to the mist close, again indicating possible errors in your traverse. So there you are, how to find some errors, gross errors, in when you're reducing traverses.